everyone, it's me, Alex.
Hi everybody, it's Miss Jessica.
Miss Jessica, where in the world are we going today?
Well, where would you like to go, Alex?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, New York City is so full of so many different cultures and foods and music and art and people, it's hard to choose.
And what do we call it when we embrace everyone's unique culture?
Cultural diversity.
Yes! In New York City, we are so culturally diverse. Exactly. But Alex, why don't we let the magic apple and the destination bowl decide? They haven't let us down yet.
Okay. I have my New York magic big apple ready. Are you ready, Miss Jessica?
I am. The destination bowl is all ready. So drum roll, please. Wow. This week, we are going to Mexico.
Mexico? Cool.
Yeah, and I have a very special friend who knows all about Mexico.
Wow.
My name is Miss Sabrina. It's so nice to meet you. ¿Cómo estás? How are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing... How do you say very well?
Muy bien.
Oh, okay. I'm doing muy bien. Was that okay?
Excelente. That was perfect, Alex.
Yay! So where are we going today, Miss Sabrina?
Today, we'll be exploring the beautiful country of Mexico.
Awesome! Can you tell me more about it?
Sure.
Mexico is a country located in the southern part of North America and is home to over 127 million people. Their national language is Spanish, o Español. Mexico has a rich and vibrant culture that dates all the way back to ancient times. Ancient Mexican civilizations, such as the Olmec, Aztec, and Maya, were extremely advanced in science, mathematics, and art. Many of the discoveries and cultural contributions of these ancient civilizations are still celebrated to this day.
That was so cool, Miss Sabrina, but all that history, it kind of made me hungry.
Well, that's okay, because we're going to be talking about food. Food is an extremely important and delicious part of Mexican culture. Families like to come together to enjoy big meals and pass down traditional recipes to each generation as a way to show their love.
Well, I definitely feel love when I eat Mexican food because I love tacos and enchiladas and
chocolate.
Huh? Chocolate?
Yes, that's right. Chocolate also comes from Mexico.
Really?
Yes. Chocolate comes from the cacao bean, which the ancient Mayans of Mexico found many uses for.
Wow! Well, thank you, Mayans. That's an amazing discovery because I love chocolate.
I have some here if you'd like.
Okay. Yay, thanks, Mr. Chocolate is so good. It just makes me want to sing.
How about we sing together? I would love to share with you some Mexican music.
Another important part of Mexican culture is música, music. One very popular music genre in both Mexico and the U.S. is Tejano music. It combines Mexican, American, and European music styles. one of the most famous Tejano musicians of all time was Selena Quintanilla Perez from the band Selena y los Dinos. In 1994, she became the first female Tejano music artist to ever win a Grammy Award.
I would love for us to sing one of my favorite songs by Selena together.
Really? What song?
This song is called Como la Flor, or in English, Like the Flower. Alex, would you do me the honors of being my dancer?
I'd be honored. I'd love to dance.
Great. Let me grab my microphone.
Sabrina, that was so much fun. Are there any other fun cultural activities about Mexico we can do?
Yes. Do you like art, Alex?
I love art. I love to color. It's one of my favorite things in the entire world.
Me too. I would love to tell you all about one of my favorite artists from Mexico, Frida Kahlo.
There are so many amazing artists from Mexico. One artist whose influence inspired the world was Frida Kahlo. Frida Kahlo was a Mexican artist who lived from 1907 to 1954. She is known best for her unique and beautiful self-portraits, which are now displayed in museums all over the world. Her style of painting was very dreamlike and expressed the different feelings she had about herself and the world around her. To this day, Frida Kahlo's powerful legacy continues to inspire women and artists around the world.
So in honor of Frida Kahlo, we're going to try creating some of our very own self-portraits. All you need to do this is a blank canvas, some paint, and a paintbrush. So let's get started. How do I see myself? Let's see. We've got long hair, a smiling face. Ooh, and let's add some flowers. I love the flowers that Frida Kahlo puts in her painting. We'll do some red, a little bit of yellow, two eyes, a nose. Let's add some finishing touches. There, all done. Would you like to see it?
Of course, Miss Sabrina.
Here it is.
Wow, look at all the flowers and your hair and your eyes are so pretty. I love it, Miss Sabrina.
Thank you so much, Alex. You know, I don't really have the artistic skills of Frida Kahlo, but it was so much fun to paint.
And that's the important thing. You don't have to be the best artist in the world, but as long as you're having fun and expressing your creativity, that's all that matters.
That's right. I also have a special surprise for you, Alex.
Really?
I made a self-portrait of you too. Can I show it?
Of course!
Here it is.
Oh my! You got my hair and my eyes and my nose and my fur. You got everything. It looks so good.
Thank you. This is a special gift for you. I'll send it to you right away.
That would be amazing. Thanks, Miss Sabrina.
Thank you, Alex. I had so much fun with you today.
And I had so much fun learning about Mexico. Hey, Miss Jessica, are there any neighborhoods in New York City that are kind of like Mexico?
Absolutely, Alex. There are so many cool places in New York.
actually in Spanish Harlem, there's a section of Spanish Harlem called Little Mexico, and there are so many cool places that you can visit to learn more about Mexican culture there. There's the Church of St. Paul, which is near the Metro North train line, and it's a center for the Latin community. There are so many stained glass windows inside. It's beautiful. There's also Mexico Lindo, which is a really fun store to go to. They sell groceries, Mexican handicrafts, so much fun stuff. You should really go.
I would love to go. Will you take me there?
Absolutely, Alex. We can go somewhere every single week.
I can't wait. We're going to go all around the world.
So exciting. I can't wait, Alex.
And join us next week when we go somewhere else. Bye, everyone.
Bye.